put David in the middle.
Thank you.
Okay, all right. All right. All right, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome, everyone, to Laredo College Fort McIntosh campus. Today is Monday, July 26, 2021. It is 5:32 p.m., and this is the Finance and Audit Committee meeting. Call this meeting to order. Go ahead and call roll. Mercurio Martinez.
Present.
Tita Vela. Esteban Rangel. Absent. Jorge Delgado. Present. All right. We'll move on to agenda item number three, the June 2021 financial report. Chair recognizes Mr. Cesar Vela.
Good evening. For the record, Cesar Vela, Vice President of Finance. Included with your board packet, you received a copy of the June 2021 financial report. I'll start the presentation by summarizing the year-to-date versus budget for as of June 30th. For the general operating fund, out of a budget of 58.6 million, we have collected revenues of 62.6 million. That's 107% of our budgeted revenue. However, we do have two payments that are pending out of the revenue, and that is a payment of 3 million for the revenue bond and a payment of 2.9 million for the maintenance tax note. Once we make those adjustments, our projected revenue for the year will be around 59.5 million. We're still pending those payments that will be sent out on Monday, actually. Now, for one other item to mention is on our tax collections. For the year, we have collected $37,083,576. We had budgeted $35 million for tax collections. We've already surpassed those projections by $2 million. Now, there are two things here that are impacting the collections. One is we budgeted a 95% collection rate. And then based on the trend that we've seen this year, we're close to about 98%. We're also looking at a discrepancy that we have between our records and the tax assessor collector. I did speak to Mr. Villarreal this afternoon to discuss this matter. And so we are actually gonna have a meeting with Ms. Barrera and her staff to review this. Both the appraisal district and the college have the same tax levy versus what the tax assessor collector has right now on her records. So we're gonna be reviewing that information. Note that right now the discrepancy is in our favor because we are showing collections above what we had projected. However, once we have that reconciliation, that number may change. But again, we are projecting that we'll be around the 98-99% collection rate for the year. And then the other item under revenues is, again, going back to our tuition and fee revenues. Right now, as of June 30th, we do have most of the summer session two already recorded. We are showing a shortfall of $1.6 million in tuition and fee revenue. Again, that shortfall is being compensated by the additional tax revenue that has come in for the fiscal year. Again, once we close the fiscal year, our projections are that we'll be around 59.5 million in revenues. As far as expenditures under the general operating fund, we have 42,708,574. That's 73% of our budgeted expenditures. We don't have any major variances in expenditures at this point. Right now, as of June 30th, we do have an increase to the fund balance of 19.9 million. Again, this obviously we're still pending the 2 months of operations. Projections are that at the end of the fiscal year, we're gonna wind up with about $4.5 to $5 million surplus. For the other funds, special appropriations, again, revenues of $159,000, expenditures of $164,000, pretty much in line, as you can see. 92% of our revenue coming from the state has been collected. 95% of the expenditures have been recorded. Auxiliary services, you can see that our revenue is $1.3 million out of a budgeted revenue of $1.5 million. Two items here to note. One is the impact of the student activity fee. Again, it has decreased this fiscal year. And then we've also seen an impact to our bookstore revenue. Again, the impact of the enrollments have also impacted the bookstore revenue. So we've seen a decrease in the bookstore commission revenue for this fiscal year. As far as expenditures, you can see that out of the $1.5 million budget that we have, expenditures of $768,000. So far, the net change to the fund balance is $538,164. For restricted funds, we have revenues and expenses of $35,398,827. The bulk of the revenue and expenditures are in Pell Awards. We have approximately, let me see if I have it here. One more. Out of the $35 million, $29 million is made up of 14 of Pell Awards and coronavirus emergency relief funding. 14.6 are Pell Awards and 14.5 million are coming from the coronavirus emergency relief funding. Now to give you an update on the emergency relief funding, from the three awards that we have received, the CARES, the CARISA, and the American Recovery Plan, we've received 50 million. Out of that, we have a balance of $33.4 million. We've awarded roughly around $17, $18 million. The bulk of that has been in student aid. Just quickly here, the comparison from 2021 to 2020, you can see that for the general operating fund, at this point last year, we had revenues of $63,692,000. This year, $62,666,000, a drop of $1 million. As well as in expenditures, last year, expenditures were at $45.1 million. This year at $42.7 million, a decrease of almost $2.5 million. Again, the net change to the fund balance at this point, we do see that at this point we have $1.4 million compared to last year. I won't go over the other funds, but you can see there that for special appropriations, we do have a $4,496 difference. And then the big change, obviously, in auxiliary services. You can see that last year we had revenues of $2 million. This year we have revenues of $1.3 million. Again, the major differences here are our student activity fee revenue and our bookstore commission revenue. One other item that's impacted has been also the housing revenue. Again, although not a big part of it, but we did see a decrease also on that one. This is just a breakdown of the information for the revenue. Again, the major differences that we're seeing are in tuition and fees. You can see that for state funds, pretty much same amount that was received last fiscal year. We do see the decreases in tuition, general use fees, and fees, and this is based, again, on enrollment and the dual program. I do want to point out that last year at this point, there was an adjustment that was pending as of June 30th, and that was for the summer session 2 information. So the data may not be 100% comparable, but at the end of the fiscal year, we'll see that adjustment being made. For expenditures, again, we do see that our expenditures have been decreased compared to last year. The only one that has increased has been our contracted services. And again, this has been mainly because we've added buildings this fiscal year, so our utility bills have gone up. Facilities Master Plan Phase 3, we began the year with a budget of $24.4 million. We had interest revenue for the year of $125,000, expenditures of $680,000 for a net change or net decrease of $555,000. So as of June 30th, we have a balance in the Phase 3 bond proceeds of $23,850,410. Now, out of that $23,850,000, we do have already a couple of projects that have been identified. The roof repairs and soffit and LED lights are roughly about $3.2 million. That project has already been approved by the board, and we're currently already starting on that work. The expansion to the diesel shop, we are projecting that that project will come in around $2.3 million, as well as the truck driving range project, and that one's estimated at $846,368. Those projects are currently in the development phase. We are projecting that the architect will be submitting the documents to the CMAR so that they can prepare a GMAX. The South Campus security upgrades project has been approved by the board, and that one's estimated to cost $750,000. We do have a couple of other projects that are pending that were identified as part of this listing. The fiber infrastructure project at $1.5 million. We're still pending to see what direction we'll go with the law enforcement training center, and as well the Ruben Garcia building. Again, the total for those projects has been identified to be $18.1 million. So that leaves us about $5 million available from the $23 million. We are working on identifying a solution to the MFA HVAC system. We do have a couple of options that we're exploring, and those range from the $2 million to the $6 million range. And again, that it all depends on what option we'll be taking. In addition, we've also identified the need to replace equipment at the South Campus. So again, right now, we do have an allocation as part of the $5 million that are left, about $3.5 million for equipment. So again, depending on some of these projects and what option we'll be taking for the MFA, we should be able to address some of the equipment needs at the South Campus. As I mentioned, we do have discrepancy that we're looking at for the tax collections. As you can see here from the report, for fiscal year 2021, as of June 30th, we have collected $37,083,576. Our tax levy, according to our records, is $36,912,505. Again, we do have that discrepancy that we're looking at. I have contacted the appraisal district, and they will be meeting with us and Ms. Barrera to review the figures for this fiscal year. And that concludes the financial report.
Mr. Chairman,
any questions?
Chair recognizes Judge Martinez.
Go back again to the very first slide, Mr. Vela. Okay, there it is. Okay. Can you tell me how come there's quite a bit of a difference on the budget to the actual revenue? Where did that additional revenue of approximately, $4.5 million more that came in?
Judge.
What was the reason for it?
Yes, no, at this point, actually, the difference is attributed to the pending payments. So far right now, out of the $62 million, we're pending to pay out $5 million for the bond payments, $3 million for revenue bonds, and $2 million for maintenance tax notes. So once we take those into account, our revenue will drop to $57 million. And then we're projecting that from here to the end of the year, we'll collect another $2 million or $2.5 million. So we're projecting that the By the end of the fiscal year, we'll wind up with about 59.5 million of revenue.
In other words, in positive numbers, added to the fund balance.
Addition to the fund balance, we're projecting about 4.5.
4.5?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
And that probably is going to come from savings, not necessarily from additional revenue at this point. It'd be more from savings than from the additional revenue.
Okay. If you will continue on with some of the expenses, the next slide, please.
I'm sorry, which one, sir?
Continue a little bit more. A little bit more. There you are. Okay. Dealing with Law Enforcement Training Center, that's 7.5 million. That would be the indoor firing range that you have in mind?
Yes, that was the original proposal or plan.
Uh-huh.
Again, that includes the indoor firing range, yes, sir.
Which would be excellent because we are able to come through with that. That will generate quite a bit of revenue from the federal government. They pretty much in effect said that they will guarantee that they will actually remain here for at least 20 years. So that obviously would be a big plus for our community and obviously for our college. So I just wanted to, and now when it comes also to the truck driving range, where will that truck driving range be ended up being built?
That is at the South Campus,
the South
Judge.
Campus?
Yes,
okay.
It's actually gonna be on the west side of the campus.
Uh-huh.
One of the practice fields will be converted into the truck driving.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Mr. Vela, the meeting with the tax assessor, when is that set to take place?
It'll probably be early next week. I'm still working on the availability. We do have on the agenda for Thursday the actual calculation of the certified tax rolls and the calculations for the non-new tax revenue from Ms. Barrera. However, I have had some conversations earlier today on the progress, and they're still waiting on some information from the State Comptroller's Office. So it may be that by Thursday that information may not be ready, and we'll have to defer it to a future meeting. But that is important because that is actually going to set the calendar for the adoption of the budget. So I'll be working with them and Mr. Muir on getting all that information ready.
Thank you very much, Mr. Vela. Any other questions? Okay. Thank you, Mr. Vela. Well, you're not leaving, but we'll move on to agenda item 4, which is the May 2021 quarterly investment report. Chair recognizes Mr. Vela.
Yes. Included in the board package for approval for this Thursday's meeting is the quarterly investment report. As of May 31st, 2021, the investments totaled $117,479,942. Out of that, $98.7 million are in bank deposits. We do have two investments in the, one in the FIT investment pool and one with TASB. $15 million with FIT and $3.7 with the TASB investment pool. The yields right now, it's 65% bank deposits. 0.65%, 0.11 for FIT investment, and TASB is 0.12, sir. Any questions?
All right. Thank you, Mr. Vela. Move on to agenda item number 5, approval for thermal storage tank roof insulation repair. Mr. Vela?
This item is, we're asking the board to approve.
Page 4.
There you go. Sorry. Yes, this item we're asking the board to approve a contract with Trane for a roof insulation repair at the Fort McIntosh Central Plant thermal storage tank. During the windstorms during May, we did have significant damage to the thermal storage tank. The repairs are expected to cost us $203,509. This has been submitted as part of the insurance claim. We have already received the check, the amount of $346,000 for all the damages that were incurred in May. Our estimates right now for damages are $331,000. I know Mr. Cano and his team are still working on compiling additional damages again, and they continue to work with the insurance company on those claims. Again, so far right now, this particular item has already been submitted to the insurance, and we have received a check already for $346,000.
Any questions from the board? Mr. Vela, I understand that we've discussed previous with regards to insurance claims. I know there was a discussion 2 months ago with regards to insurance claims that popped up, that there was issues with the adjuster or issues with the estimates.
Was that, I don't remember that particular.
It was in April, if I'm not mistaken. Or if not, is there a way you can provide this committee, I guess, a list of all the insurance claims?
Sure.
That have popped up and that have been paid by the insurance company?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
We have that information now. I'll work with Mr. Cano and Mr. Dr. Ariasola on getting that information.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, we'll move on to agenda item number 6, which is the approval for chill water line pump replacement at Fort McIntosh Central Plant. Mr. Vela, the floor is yours.
Yes. This one item is again requesting that the board approve a contract with Train to replace a chill water line pump. And also that they approve a transfer of $66,240.25 from the general operating fund balance to the physical plant fund balance to cover the cost of the replacement. Couple of months ago, the board approved the replacement of the primary pump number 1 on the secondary loop. While they were doing this work, they discovered that the second pump was malfunctioning, and the recommendation has been to replace that second pump. Again, the scope of work will entail obviously acquiring a new pump and the labor that will entail replacing the pump. Again, the cost is $66,240.25, and it is being purchased using a buy board contract number 631-20.
Any questions from any members of the board? When was the last time this was replaced?
This particular pump, we replaced one, which was, there's two, I don't remember exactly when, it's been a while.
Okay.
We have not, actually, we hadn't done any work on those pumps. Part of that also, some of the valves had to be replaced. As part of that process, so I believe
that's
that this
basic maintenance.
Yes.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much, Mr. Vela. We'll move on to agenda item number 7: approval for the purchase of furniture for Memorial Hall Building, Office 211, using Facilities Master Plan Phase 2 bond savings. Mr. Vela.
Yes, members of the board. This particular item is request the approval to purchase furniture for one of the offices at Memorial Hall. Memorial Hall was part of Phase 2 Facilities Master Plan. When we did that project, we did address furniture and equipment for that building. However, for this particular office, we did not purchase any furniture in this particular area because we were using it as a temporary housing for the library and the learning center while they were working on the Erie Library. So since we didn't have any tenants going into that building, we did not purchase the furniture at that time. We do have savings in the Facilities Master Plan Phase 2 bonds that we have identified to make this purchase. Again, the total amount is $9,727.
Any questions from any members of the committee? Thank you, Mr. Vela. Move on to agenda item number 8, which is the approval for purchase of equipment through CARES Act. Mr. Vela?
Yes. This item is to request approval to purchase audiovisual equipment from Audiovisual Aids in the amount of $108,808. And then the purchase is being made using Viber contract number 579-19. Again, this is audiovisual equipment, camera equipment that is being purchased for 5 classrooms in the business department. And again, the purchasing of this equipment will help us with socially distancing students, as well as providing instruction via virtual instruction, I'm sorry. And again, the funding for this equipment is coming through CARES Act funding.
And this is to upgrade certain equipment there, correct?
There is actually, my understanding, this is more for new equipment that is, these classrooms are not equipped for that, okay, for that purpose.
Yeah. Any questions for members of the committee? All right, thank you, Mr. Vela. We'll move on to agenda item number 9, approval of 48-month lease for the purchase of Dell computer equipment. Mr. Vela?
Yes, this is to request a 48-month lease to purchase Dell computer equipment in the amount of $657,314.74, using a 48-month lease from First American. The equipment is being purchased using the DIR contract TXDIR TSO 3763, and financing is being done through First American using a lease rate factor of 0.2622. We did compare Dell leasing option. However, First American offered us a better rate. The estimated annual payments will be $165,972.60. This amount is budgeted as part of the IT lease purchase line item. The equipment that we're purchasing will be to replace computer lab equipment. Included with your board packet is a copy of the Dell quote, and we're looking at about 634 computers, Optiplex computers, and 30 Precision 5820 towers, along with the monitors. And again, this will be to upgrade some of the computer labs that we have here, both at the Fort McIntosh and South campuses.
Mr. Vela, how old are is the current equipment at the computer?
We try to replace equipment every 4 to 5 years. Okay. So, computers tend to be obsolete in 1 to 2 years.
Yeah. Obsolete tomorrow. Okay. Any questions for members of the committee? Thank you, Mr. Vela. Number 10, agenda item number 10, approval to use fiscal year 2021 savings to purchase equipment for fiscal year 2022 operations.
Yes. As part of the budget for 2022, the budget committee has made the recommendation to use savings from this fiscal year to purchase equipment. Originally, the equipment came in at $1.5 million. The budget committee worked and reduced that amount to $868,886. Some of the equipment that did not make this list was identified to be purchased through CARES Act funding or grant funding. Included is a listing of the equipment that is being requested. Again, we are projecting that we're going to have savings of $4.5 million at the end of the fiscal year. When we take into account the purchase of this equipment, we should have a net savings of $3.6 million once we close out the fiscal year. And again, these are preliminary, but again, right now, based on the information that we have, we're looking at least $4.5 million for savings.
Mr. Chairman?
Chair recognizes Judge Martinez.
Thank you. What type of equipment are you have in mind as far as acquisition?
We have from all the departments, we have instructional equipment, but also for support services. We do have some safety equipment that's being requested. We do have a request to purchase an additional truck for the truck driving program, as well as equipment for the diesel and auto technology program. So it's a combination of equipment that is needed both in instructional areas and support areas. Again, the listing is included in the packet for your review. And of course, if you guys have any questions, you can always
I have heard very, very good comments in reference to what the Border Patrol people are going through out here, and I also, you know, from actual Border Patrol people that are in enrolled out here, is there any contemplation of the possibility of buying additional equipment in reference to what they're going through right now? Any idea?
My understanding is that they'll be providing the equipment. We provide the facility.
I see.
As part of the facility's master plan, obviously one of the projects that's identified there is to doing some upgrades to the Lopez Nursing and the Ruben Garcia Allied Health buildings. I know right now one of the major items that we're working on is replacing two air handlers that are that need to be replaced. But right now, my understanding is that the Department of Homeland Security will provide the equipment. We provide the facility.
Which is even
the
better
facility.
For us, because that, apparently that equipment will remain with the college, presumably.
Not sure on that, Judge, yet, because it's specialized equipment that they utilize for their training. So
I see.
Might be,
okay.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Mr. Vela, just two questions. One under technology support, and maybe, I mean, obviously you'll answer this for me, but has listed, the first line item has listed iPads for $3,500. And it says quantity one, is that correct?
That is correct.
What kind of iPad is that?
I would need to go back and double check on that. I'll make a note.
I don't think there's any iPad that costs that much.
No. It might be that they lumped some the amount.
Okay. So I think they lumped a bunch of it together. Yeah. They have to.
Yeah, if we could just make sure just to fix that, especially for the quantity of the amount. And then the second thing was in regards to several of these purchases that are under these departments, is there any, I shouldn't say requirement, but is there any recommendation that can be given to make sure that these are purchased through local entities here?
Yes, sir. As a matter of fact, right now you're not actually approving
the
purchase. No. It's just the us being able to go out and start the procurement process.
Okay. Gotcha.
But for example, the phone system cloud migration, that item most likely needs to come back to the board.
Mm-hmm.
And at that point, again, if we do have local vendors that offer that service, obviously we'll reach out to them.
Okay. Perfect. Well, thank you very much, Mr. Vela.
Thank you.
Thank you for taking the time and the entire meeting staying up there. Appreciate it. There's no other questions from members of the committee?
I do.
Yes, Chair recognizes Ms. Vela.
Is there any way to, can we do it right now? Put 5 through 10 as a consent item? Items 5 through 10 as a consent?
Well, I believe all these items are going to be consent.
Yeah, they should
all
be
of them are?
Yes.
Okay.
Perfect.
Just
to. We can always change it in the board meeting, too. So. All right. There's no further questions or concerns. If I could have a motion for adjournment.
I'll. Motion to adjourn.
All right, we have a motion, Judge. We have a second.
I have second.
Those one. Were just three.
That's true. That's all I can. All right, motion. Meeting
motion
adjourned.
Carries. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone, so much. Appreciate it.
Thank you.